Hello, in this video, I'm going to give a brief overview of hormone receptor-positive breast cancer. If you want to learn more, we have a whole playlist about hormone receptor-positive breast cancer. In this video, I'll talk a little bit about what it means and why it matters and the different types of treatment. Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to this channel and to go to Yerbba.com to get your personalized breast cancer Yerbba report. Hormone receptors refers to two hormone receptors on breast cancer cells. These are the estrogen receptor and the progesterone receptor. That's what we mean when we're talking about hormone receptors. These are not related to hormones in your body. They're rather related to proteins that we test for on tumor cells. So when we test for hormone receptors, this is done on the surgical specimen or the biopsy of the breast cancer. These tests are done in 100% of people with breast cancer. So if you don't have the results of your hormone receptors yet, you will soon. Hormone receptors are, if you think about them as sort of seats that estrogen and progesterone and other hormones can sit in from our body, can sit in those cells, they kind of facilitate those cells to grow and divide. They don't necessarily feed the cancer, but cancer cells that are already there will be facilitated or maybe sped up a little bit by hormones in the body. Now, we make these hormones no matter how old we are. And in fact, hormone receptor positive breast cancers are more common in older people. Just to show you how clearly separate this is from hormones in your body. We test for these tumors that as I mentioned, in the pathology lab. So a biopsy will be done and then it's sent to the pathologist and the pathologist does these tests. This can be done on a biopsy or on the final surgical specimen or both. And in people who have disease in other parts of the body can be biopsied as well and tested for the same hormone receptors. Why does it matter? Well, there are a couple things. Hormone receptor status is associated with both prognosis and with prediction of response to certain treatments. So if no other treatments were given, if you just had surgery or just had a biopsy, having hormone responsive tumors, hormone receptor positive breast cancer, what that means is that your outcome will be better in the absence of any treatment. That means it's a prognostic factor. Having hormone receptors on the tumor is also a predictive marker. It predicts that you will respond to anti-estrogen therapy. And there are two types of this, tamoxifen and the aromatase inhibitors. And there's some other things as well, like LHRH analogs. Check out our playlist because we go through all of those. Briefly, what we like to do in tumors that are positive for ER and or PR is we want to reduce the dance between your body's hormones and the tumor cell. And we can do that either by blocking your body's hormones, that's this little hand here, from hitting the receptor, or by decreasing your body's hormones. And I won't go into details because there's a lot more to learn. This is really just an overview. If you've been diagnosed with breast cancer and you're early on, I'd love to invite you to go to Yerbba.com. Your Yerbba report, created on Yerbba.com, goes through all of your medical records that are available after you give permission, and then generates a report of all the treatments you've had and what might still be happening, what might be yet to come, and then looks at the most recent medical literature and tells you about treatments that may or may not be offered to you and the pros and cons of each treatment. Different from your portal, which you can see reports from, and not a static report. It's not a one-time report. It's updated as you go through different parts of the treatment process. Thank you so much for watching today. We'll see you next time.